Not now. Didn't want to accept too many crests. Okay, then we're back again. I decided that I want to do the Harzul quest right now. Might be a mistake, might be not. First I have to scout him, and then I need to pull up some rage, of course. Or pull some rage. Copper. So there are like grey centaurs over here. Can easily pull some rage on those. Shouldn't have used blood fury here. Blood rage. Should have used it after the combat. So yeah, my plan is just to pull retaliation. Dynamite, everything. I think it's gonna be easy. I go in, retaliation immediately, debuff, shot into thunderclap, and if things get too scary, throw down target dummy, pull some of those mobs off me. That way. So he patrols. If he's 2 to 3, or I guess 1 to 3 guys. And he spawns about here. He moves like clockwise around the oasis, so if I go counterclockwise, I can I maximize my chances to encounter him. There's, you see? There he is. It's clear here. Two crits. There's another stormer. Want to get rid of him. Let's take this brew. Please don't kill him. Buff up the stamina. So he's level 19 and he has some blood chargers, but they should die extremely fast. Okay, let's go in. Yeah, no problem at all. Like, look at those guys, man. Dude, they got annihilated. But I somehow hit instead of charge, I hit my potion. So let's get this on. Dude, like what is wrong with me? No. Oh, I could have timed it so that I get level up in that fight, which would have been extremely nice. Deflection. Let's go get some more parry. I'm like really good against melees or physical, but I'm kinda weak against casters. So I have to watch out for that. Always got to be careful with those casters. The good thing is that Mace stun is really good against casters. And not only that, like if we get intercept finally at some point against casters, you can just charge in, throw like any spell really, like doesn't matter, maybe Thunder Ammo or Rend, and just run out and intercept back in again to stun him three seconds and maybe interrupt the cast. And after that you can just pummel the next cast. So here, as soon as we get pummel, casters are no problem because casters have low armor every time. All caster mobs have low armor. I don't know if it's 100%, but 99% of the time they have low armor, and if we pummel the casts, then we are going to be really fine against casters. And we are good against melee as well, because we have improved Thunderclap, improved Demo Shout, parry and everything. So this build is really like well-rounded, really good. This build will be, I'm convinced that this build will be extremely good. Like we go down to Mace Specialization now as soon as possible. Then we see what you wanna do. I think I'm gonna get improved Intercept. Yeah, I'm gonna get improved Intercept. I think I maybe do not get improved Twin Specialization. And I don't know if I want to get Deep Wounds. Get Deep Wounds. Because it scuffs my fear into bandage.
Blood and Thunder.
Counter attack. Suggest player 3. Nope, not now, or maybe even never. So there we get the ring, really good. It's 1 stamina, 3 agi, 11% crit. Alright, we have almost 1 more hour to record. Or like 1 more hour, because some of this stuff will be speed up, or will be fasted forward. So the Elder Crone, in Thunder Bluff. Alright. So we want to get to Kemptarayu, and after that we want to go to Thunder Bluff again. And then the Guns of Northwatch we're gonna do last. I hope it's not our last quest. Or maybe we wait until it's green, actually. Cause this is no joke. There's a lot of things that can go wrong in us on this quest. And I maybe want to do it at night. Because if there are other people around, it can really scuff us. So yeah, I want to be at least level 22 for this quest, I think. Until then, I can just do some other stuff. Later. So let's create some anti-venom. Get some more wool bandage. Free up those inventory space here. And the line cloth I want to keep. Alright. Kemptarayu. Kemp, how are you? Northwatch hold. Yeah. So we are almost done with the barons for now. Of course the next quests will be down here. And I think there are like level 24 mobs and stuff like this. Which is like way above what we can handle easily. Or what we can handle safely. Even though the quest to complete the quest would be extremely nice, because we could get the hammer. Maybe I want to do this little adventure, but this wouldn't be for this episode, because it might take longer than an hour, and I want to buff up for that. With the stones, you know? It's dumb that I don't have the stones on me right now anyways, this is like super idiot. Kill Nakus and Luke Orkbane, yes. Damn.
How?
The Ashen Veil Hunt? No.
Walk with the Earth Mother.
Speak Riff. Okay.
The Eternal Sun. What brings you here?
No, I don't want to do this quest right now. So this one is orange. Thunder Lizard Blood. Those are the flying things, I think. They're flying around here. Light feather. There was some. The door is wingle tingle ding dong, so have to pause for a second here and open the door. Alright, we're back. So let's land some more thunder lizards. Or maybe it's the other things. Thunder lizard. Maybe it's not the snakes actually. Why are they giving us like a shield for the warrior crest and the one-hander? I'm a little bit offended. Like here, you know you can tank if you put on a shield and a one-hander. Like, give me a fucking break, man. You could even tank with two-hander, so... And you're more efficient with that as well, so why are you giving the warriors one-hander and the shield, man? It's offensive. Just assume my playstyle. I don't really know what to kill for the crest. You will find thunder lizards in the southwestern Southern Barrens. They are known as Storm Snoot. Yeah, this is a storm head. Storm snoot, storm hides, and thunder heads. Okay, so those are the right thing to kill. Can you please? I hate those mobs. I really do. I don't want to move, man. There's one. There's a special one that can spawn here. It's like a blue one. He drops a crest, I think. It's a rare, but he isn't here right now. The rare isn't there. Blood Fury here. Raptor Sanders immediately. Wait for dodges or parries. Parry. I'm losing a lot of rage with this method. Kinda questionable. What is this? Why was it blinking? I need to make the damage numbers visible. Like the damage that I take. Combat? Here, enable floating combat text. What the fuck? Wait, what is it offline? Reputation changes, yeah, why not? Okay. So now I've done this one. So it's basically Captura Eurobust.
Greetings.
Find and slay Thunderhawk. Return during the turn. Trended staff. So bad things. Want to get my hands on the hammer. So I'm just gonna accept this crest. Cause I already know that I want to go down there. Weapons of choice, yes. So, weapons of choice is our orange crest. Yeah, that's what I thought. I cannot do it right now. Here, your target. Oh, interesting. But if I equip it, it will have the cooldown of 30 seconds. So this would, it's kind of troll. 100 isn't that much, even right now. Now we have the combat text. This is really important for us. Unfortunately, we don't get any parries or dodges. So there is a level 22 Thunderhawk Cloud Scraper. He's strong, I think. Oh, not a great start. Or does it matter? He's not strong enough. Four bars on the way to level 22. I hope I get something really good at level 22.
What brings you here?
So the 200 staff is not really good. He's really fast, but not really good. And the gloves, they are really good. So at least there's something. Coast, it is held by humans. Find my sister, Marhen Shihans, the greater water beasts along the coast. She will be your teacher in their race. Here, why not? Oh, I just figured it's only 9 more levels to Berserker Stance.
Well met.
That's cool. I really want to have Berserker Stance, and I really want to have Intercept. 1 gold. Alright, so let's. What can we do here? We could do Guns of Northrage. What would be extremely dangerous. And then we could go to Stone Talon back again.
Peace, friend.
Do we have enough time for the Guns of Northrage quest? No, I don't. So I'm going to Thunderbluff and do something in Stone Talon Mountains. Here's a crest, he had a crest. Oh yeah, I could accept the crest and ratchet with the Moose Axe. like I'm only traveling all the time. Yeah, this has to go. The rule has to go. I think. I'm gonna give you some time to decide that. If no one answers me, I will just put down this one rule. Because yeah, like I said for 1,000 times now, it's just annoying. Taran, capital of Thunderbluff from the Elder's Rise. So again, I need to speak with someone in the Elder Rise. Too bad that my trainer is not at the Elder Rise. What is with the Hearthstone? 30 minutes. Alright, I'm back again. So, here, maybe you saw in the speed up part, accepting the Wailing Caverns crest with the Serpent Bloom. And I'm pretty sure that the mobs in the pre dungeon are like non elites, and there's Serpent Bloom in there, so I can do it. And I think I can even do the crest with the where I have to gather some of those pelts, you know, like some of those hides, how are they called, Deviard hide or something like this. I think I can do them as well. I will accept the crest and see about that. I think there is a good, there are some good stuff you get from the crest, good rewards, and yeah, then there is even some other crests and ratchet, like the one where you have to get the alcohol. And I think the mob is not an elite. If he is an elite, well, we have to fight, I guess. If he isn't, it's good. And then we can do maybe the Eker crest as well, because I think there are some of those Eker slimy thingies in the dungeon as well, in the pre-dungeon that drops for the crest. Hey, yeah. Right, the 99 old port.
Glad I could help.
We want to do that right now. What is he has? He has Serpent Spider Axe. Smart Drinks. Blue Leaf Tubers. Grab a crate of no. I know this quest. Smart drinks. Potion, Wailing, assassins. Yeah. I think that's everything. And we have to go on top of the railing caverns.
Hey, how you doing?
So we take some of those with us just in case. Oh no, we don't need to. I can just speed up the parts when I'm doing like barring stuff like that. Like picking this up to go to Tarayu and shit. I can just speed it up. Speed it up. Speed it up. So yeah, let's get some action going, right? This will be interesting. The crossroads. Get a cigarette going. This is like the good part. If you stream for like a small or like small community or like no community at all, I guess I can just do what I want. Or I guess do videos right now. Going like 3 hours without smoking, but still being like kind of stressed out because of the format is kind of hard, to be honest. I could do it if I have to, but right now I really don't have to. Yeah, I want to get some more food. Yeah, if you don't like the crests in Ashen Vale, like I do, you have to get a little bit creative. So get some melons in here. Steady should be enough. I hope. If everything goes bad, we have to kill some of the elite mobs in the dungeon solo. But I think I can pull it off. If the crest is green, I can definitely pull it off. So first we have to get into the cave. Make the little jump thingy. Like, did you catch my HP right now? 666. I don't know if this is a good sign or a bad sign for what we want to do. Give me a little taxi here, mister. Thank you. Don't taste me, please. Man, we are really missing out on some shoulders right now. This is like a little bit frustrating. I would really like to have some nice good shoulders. Good shoulders with like 100 armor or stuff like this. If I would be a blacksmith right now, I could craft some. So blacksmithing wouldn't be that bad for this challenge, especially when you come to Outlands, and maybe the Thorium set has some hit on it as well. I wanted to look it up, and if that's the case, I might swap professions. But I think I would swap, like, in the moment I can use and craft a hit set from my level, and then I would stop. And then I would make a huge profession session. So hello.
Feel free to browse.
Do you sell shoulder pads, maybe? No. New black and the Wailing Caverns want 20 divi yard heights. 10 slot back. Divi yard Viper, divi yard Shamrus, and divi yard Dead Fangs. These gloves are huge. But I don't think I can do it in the pre-dungeon. That crest, that is. So I will not accept it right now. First we have to look at the mobs that are in the pre. So they are not elite. They are even grey. So let's get them. Diviard Creeper. Yeah, they dropped the Viad Heart. This is really nice. Nice, we can do these quests in here. Though there's the dungeon group. There's a serpent bloom, so I was right on that part as well. Nice, this works out really well. Unless I die in here, of course. These are really good as well, give me some rage. Level 22, I get some really nice stuff. Now these ones can inflict me with this, which decreases my stamina. This looked kind of funny, how you like jumped and then slowly went into this beautiful position when picking up the flower. So, and those guys, those guys should drop the Iker that I need, I think. Clone. Yes, nice. Works out just perfectly. Then I'm gonna swoop into the dungeon as well and see if I can kill those mobs. And then I could maybe do this dungeon quest solo. Unfortunate that this dungeon group killed everything. We'll get respawns and stuff as well. They looted my serpent bloom, everything. And now they wait even. Can you please push on? Do it at least fast. Some rage here. Nice. Dude. Can you heal him, please? I think those can drop the Deviant hide as well. Okay, this clone ability is a little bit annoying. Boots? No, no boots. It's fake boots. Lurker. Deviant Lurker. Stop it, please. Your end is becoming like so shitty. Bring two thunderers and one hamstring. Just in case they want to run away. Level 22 we get new beta shot and new thunder armor. Is extremely good. Or crit, look at that. So wool bandage. Up two thunders in him. He's a slayer. I don't know if it was part of the quest to kill slayers. Is crystal or green? Four of those. Five hide already, which is good. Let's get the buff. We can get a buff from the guy in the Wailing Caverns. Thank you. Percent with one Arthur. Not some bandage sticks. Greet me for 100 almost. Yeah, I kept run around. Okay, yeah. Didn't really made it. But I could. If I want to, like in one more level or so, I could try. Reset the dungeon all over and try to get some stuff out of this guy, but don't think it's really interesting. Now we will get respawns in here, which is dangerous. At least we have the dungeon, like for an escape route. We get the intimidating shout as well on the level up. So it's kinda dangerous to just charge in here. So it's like rank 2 or rank 3. I think it's rank 2. So it already gives us some stats. Dropped weapon? Maybe it's worth to train and to do a little bit of fist training, you know? It might very well be worth it. Okay. We try to dodge this slime. Maybe cancel the thing. Come on, dude. Deus crits. Deus crits. A little bit of buff material. Too bad I'm not the leather working and skinning. With skinning I think you can get more hide from them. Only 6 height. Yeah, the height crest will be a little bit annoying. So now please. No, I missed it. Okay. He can crit for... Okay, never mind. Bandage. Can do any more? No, I can't. two more. Three enough for now. The one bandage. The one big bandage I have left. So, can't really mess around too much. So I'm just gonna try to dump my rage and then get into defensive stance. Missed. These guys, holy shit, they're annoying as hell. Especially because the clone doesn't even drop anything. 30 on crit, gotta keep that in mind. Crit for 31. Dropping revenge, yes. Get used to disrupting a little bit. What is going on here? Inventory is full. Okay. Okay, this is like always pretty useless. So let's take this one. Can we kill this ectoplasma without him? Let's take. Yes, nice. Eight hides. The wrong button. Could have revenged here in this fight. There it is. Revenge next rank is on level. It's. Level 24, yes, 24. Those guys drop, fuck. Those guys, do they drop? Dude, oh no. I didn't swap the stance. Just annoying. Sting. Slash. They even have an annoying name. Getting stung is annoying. Being lashed is annoying. Nice, I like this stance swapping method. I think it's really funny. Really engaging, you know? It's a lot of action. Is he turning around? No? What is he doing? Okay. There's this one. Oh, there's the stealth man. Where's the stealth guy? I kinda want to get him out first. Even though I can easily take on two or three. Get up, shout. Dude. Okay, they do drop the rear tide. Stop, please. No. No reason to throw the first thunder before the shout, because the first outer attack will not profit from the thunder because it's too slow, or the outer attack is too fast, comes out too fast, and yeah, therefore. It's not very smart to do it like this. I should do it like... Okay, oh, I didn't have any rage. Times 18 damage for 10 rage. Not good. Shouldn't throw the rend. Depends if I crit or not, I guess. Yeah, yeah. Crit, don't throw red. Damage. I don't want to get the disease. Here. Render was wasted again. They're running together. Pull some rage. Get shot. Be refreshed. Now I can like engage on him. Boop. Sorry, it's the selfie. Oh, not you again. Everything keeps going like this, they eat up all my grenades. It's against multiple mobs. Still want to fight that. To drop this stuff. What's revenge? Range is putting in some work here with this method. Kinda proud. Get this ass over here. Here could respawn soon, so I should use this one as a safe space. First thunder misses, so I throw up a rent. Still not really worth it. I'm just gonna stop rending. Ooh. Got a revenge proc. Fast. Not fast enough. I don't want to use the rent anymore. Smart things. They do like zero damage when I'm in defensive stance. Instead of the first thunder, but because of the thunder my auto attacks will produce more rage because they do more damage. I want it again. This is a bad habit. Revenge. Yes. 6 hearts. There is the dumb fuck method again. Of freeze the flying thunder before the shot. Let's try this. And here. Now thunder. Still. Nothing really. Rent didn't have any value here. Let's throw a cleave. shoulders. Shoulderless orc.
I can't carry anymore.
Let's pull these two. Green one hander. Two hands. Oh, it's bad. Oh, this is so sad. See first. 2-8. Dry him out a little bit. Of course I miss.
Need more rage. Need more rage.
Another revenge again. Nice. I really liked the render, but he's just way weaker than the axe. I think. 6 down. Edgy and strength. Not bad. I want to pull him. Okay. He kinda comes this way anyways. One more, so we can go start to run out. I resisted, I think it was the knockback or knockdown. We are easy cave clearing here. Easy peasy. Sorry, did some nice dungeon quests. This will be, I think, nice amounts of XP and everything. Goblin is not here. Or I'm getting headaches right now. It monitor it for the respawn. Was a little bit too early to go out. Little bit dumb on my part. So when these are respawning, then the rest should respawn, right? Should be very soon. Corpses already despawned. There's the respawn. So this is going to be a little bit dangerous. But we are going to take this one and just drag it up here, and we hope that we are fast enough. And done. And now we run out. So that's four crests, four dungeon crests. Which is good gold, and we need a little bit of gold right now. This one, I really enjoy this one. 10 slot bag comes into this porch slot, so we get rid of this brown porch, which we don't like, obviously. Because it's the same porches that the vendor sells and stuff, so it's not cool, you know. And we can keep our lucky pouches. I like this sword a lot. It's fast. Do I keep it instead of the axe? Maybe. I think I'm not going to sell it right now. Only if I really need to, and I'm going to play a little bit with that and see if it's better than the axe, or if it feels better and they're like same. Like, my dream is to get a fast mace, I think. A fast two-handed mace. And then later, if we get, when we pick up Mortal Strike, if we do that, then we want to swap to a another mace, to a very slow one. Hard hitting, that is. Slow, it doesn't need to be slow, but it should hit very hard. Nice, got the Rebecca.
We shall meet again.
Beautiful. No, no. Sorry, I have to go now. I think it's Ratchet for the most part. Here it's all in Ratchet. So we're gonna end this episode in Ratchet. And next record we maybe want to do Northrush. Or we want to go to here to Stone Talon. I picked up the crest with the moose eggs. Deep moose egg. Yeah, it's still yellow, so we could very well do this before the Guns of Northrush. They are put into this order, so I think the Guns of Northrush will take a lot longer to go green. When I'm 22 and I can afford all my skills, I'm not really afraid anymore of the crest, of the Guns of Northrush crest. Unless they can heal, some of the mobs can heal, I think. And I don't have a pummel, because I'm not allowed to use the shield.
Interesting.
this one is in Sonderbluff. Sonderbluff. So let's just take some of those with us. Of course, we go to Sonderbluff soon. We have enough of those. We have enough. No, we don't really have enough of those, but we can't really craft more either. So this is okay. Here.
Be good.
Oh, this we wanted to sell before we stop the episode. I'm doing great, thank you. There. All right.
Have a good one.
This is no inn. Let's log out in the inn for the blue XP. Parry, yeah, 5 levels more of parry. Or 4 levels, sorry, 24, when we get parry to full, and then we can start, 25, and then we can start thunderclapping. Alright guys, that's it for this episode, hope you enjoyed, and here, let me know if I can just cancel the rule with the crests, so, see you in the next video.